Yes, ladies and gentlemen, the time has come to begin our full walkthrough for Dark Souls 3. So I know I say this a lot, but there really are no words at all for how just I'm like, my entire body is shivering in anticipation right now. I'm so excited for this. So, couple things I want to say before we start. Based on some feedback I got from Bloodborne, this first series of videos will be blind. It'll be a gameplay style walkthrough, you know, because we still figure out bosses and whatnot, but we are going in blind, going to learn as we go. I think a lot of you guys kind of appreciate my reaction and seeing me figure out stuff more than just, you know, having me know everything ahead of time. So after the fact, there will be a more, you know, kind of 100% walkthrough to actually guide people through it. But this one's for all those people that they just want to see me in raw cowboy form, I guess we should say. Anyway, let's press the button. Oh my god, I'm so excited! I'm so excited. I can't believe I'm playing this right now.
Yes, indeed. It is called Lothric, where the transitory lands of the Lords of Cinder converge. In venturing north, the pilgrims discover the truth of the old words. The fire fades, and the lords go without thrones. When the link of fire is threatened, the bell tolls, unearthing the old lords of Cinder from graves. Aldrich, Saint of the Deep.
It's gotta be like a tentacle monster. Like, straight Cthulhu, slimy tentacle man.
Farron's undead legion, the Abyss Watchers.
Obviously, gonna be totally badass when we get to them. They just look like they're there to murder you.
And the reclusive lord of the profaned capital. Yon the Giant.
I just hope he is as big as he looks in the cinematic. Like, I want this guy to be enormous when we fight him. Oh man. Oh god, I'm so excited!
Only in truth, the lords will abandon their thrones. And the unkindled will rise.
Yes.
Nameless, accursed undead, unfit even to be Cinder. And so it is that Ash seeketh embers.
You know, I've seen that at least 10 times now, and it's still epic every time. Every time, it's still as good as it was the first time. All right, so. Uh-oh, no, don't do this to me, controller. I moved the mouse slightly, and now the controller is like, you're gonna use me? Oh, here we go, controller's working again. Okay, name. cowboy. Actually, just in case it has a name and world, we'll go with that. Age. He's a mature man. And we are going pyromancer. So I was on the fence, you know, I did knight before, and knight seemed really strong, but I feel like everyone's gonna play knight, so I didn't want to do that. Mercenary looked like it could be really badass, especially because it has the dual-wield scimitars that I was smashing stuff with back in the network test. So I think that's likely going to be the second class I play. Warrior, obviously, for the strength build. But, man, there's something about pyromancy, you know? Pyromancy is so much fun. So I'm going pyromancer. As for our gift, I know I can find a life ring. Fully restores FP. Fire gem. Ooh. Sovereignless soul. Sovereignless soul of one who slept beside you. Oh. Item discovery. Cracked red eye. Young white. Blend into the environment but only once. Well, I would say a fire gem. I think starting with a fire gem and enchanting a weapon would be pretty dope. Let's do that. These faces are kind of bloodborne-ish. Whoa. Features of the old gods, as if legend, they say children born like this are fated to be taken to the Boreal Valley. Hollow Londor is a realm of the hollow and old. The swamp people. Visage of a true dragon. It kind of reminds me of the High Elves from Skyrim. Known for its zest for life and love of drink. I mean, that's got to be the drunk through character, obviously. Men of the Cloth. Dragon Academy. An old. Yeah, let's just go with the commoner face. Really? I can't do any all the facial changes. God, he's so skinny. Why are you so skinny, bro? Yeah, make him a little buff. Like, don't be this. Oh, here we go. Appearance. That's where I'm gonna change it all. Age, mature voice. Yeah, give him some thick body hair. Build detail. His head's kind of small. Let's put his head up a little bit. Yeah, he needs a huge chest. Pull the abdomen down just a pinch. Massive arms. Make those legs bigger. Alright. Hair. I want to change the hair. So, pyromancer dude. Let's give him, kind of the faux hawk. Yeah, let's do that. He's going to be a pyromancer, so let's go for, like a red? A reddish? Kind of just like slightly red. Yeah, like there's just a pinch of red in there that you can see. His brow. No. Maybe. Unibrow man. Let's go with that one. Brow color. Gotta have a beard. No, looks like he has like pubes on his face. That one's not bad. I want this beard or this beard. No, that's too short. And this is too bushy. Let's go with this one. And we'll do the same color on the beard. His eyelashes are so important because we're going to totally see those while we're playing. Pupils. Color of pupil. Ooh, I can change the actual pupil. Ooh. I think something like this. Like, you know, like he was blinded. He was blinded from playing with fire. Give him some kind of badass lore. Playing with fire left him blind in both eyes, but he senses people through the power of pyromancies. Phoenix, dragon, Pegasus. Twerk it. Oh, tweak. I was like, why am I twerking this? No, I want it to put like on his back. Why? I don't want the sun on my face. I want like a giant praise the sun tattoo on my back. I don't think I can do that. Can I zoom, rotate. Okay, maybe I can. Just a scroll of text on my head. Make it like a scar, kind of. That was from his battle with a fire dragon. Alright, I like it. Oh, no, 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 keep that. This is good. Okay. Yeah, sure, why not? Save it to a favorite. Let me do his beard. I mean, I'm kind of happy with this face shape now that I've actually modified some of the other stuff. His nose is me. It's a slight tweak to the nose. Eyes are gonna make slightly bigger. Oh, maybe not. No, well. Yeah, I think I like him a little bigger. Like right there. I want a little bit more red in his beard. Where was that at? Face detail, facial hair, beard color. There we go. Just because of the way the beard is, I'm gonna have to make it a little bit more red for it to actually be visible. Like that. All right, I think he's good. I think he is ready. Appearance set, build set, presets. Let's do this, baby. So whereas before, you know, obviously when we were at the event, we just hauled ass through the game. That's not gonna be the case here. We are every frickin' nook and cranny we are gonna explore. So, should be a really good time. Obviously, with this being the first episode, as soon as this one's done, I'm going to check the audio. Because I know there were a lot of people mentioning that the audio on the very first part that we uploaded from the San Francisco event was all kinds of weird. And part of that was just because of, you know, the nature of that event. Let's see. Pyromancy flame. What do I have here? Great swamp ring boost pyromancies. Okay. Physical. So this thing has shit for defense. Can't be blocking with that. Hand axe. Let's see what the hand axe. Okay. So that has the buff. Regular attack. Yeah, we know this. What I find interesting is, even though we have it, come on, man. All I wanted to do was a parry. Even though we're playing with the PlayStation controller, it defaults to Xbox controls, which I found kind of interesting, considering PlayStation has kind of been like the, you know, the standard home of Souls for a very long time, so... I noticed that in the menu that I had to hit square and it said to hit X. Alright. That. Free backstabs! I gotta say, seeing the Dark Souls 1 backstabs being back is pretty awesome. Oh my god! No! No, sir! We are not dying this early! Eat a fireball to the face. What's over this way? Whoa, what is that? Oh, man. I don't think I should fuck with that. No, no, I should probably just back away. That thing does not look friendly. That thing says... Just looking at it, that's like, sup. I'm gonna kill you right now. Oh god, please, giant crystal lizard thing, go away. Oh man, how far is this thing gonna chase me? Oh my god! Ah! Oh, it's just shooting icicles everywhere, please leave me alone! Oh man, it's still coming. I'm like, legitimately scared of that. Please, good sir. I mean, I want to take that thing on. Oh god, it's still coming. I mean, I want to, but I'm not right now. Right now is a bad time to decide to take that on. I need to get to the first bonfire. There we go. First bonfire. Alright, now that I have this, I can take this guy on. God rest. There, we are nowhere remotely close to spending this much time in the cemetery of Ash before. But now it's like, shit. This is going to be a full episode of just me in the cemetery of Ash. Well, then again, character creation took a while, too. I wasn't about to go in with a half-cocked character. No, sir. Alright, so what about this way? I think this is the original path. Is this back where I spawned? Yeah, control camera. Okay. I really gotta practice my parries. I mean, this shield is not built for parrying, but I need to... to practice them and get a hold of them. Way too late. Alright, so that was the way back to the bonfire, just going up there. What was over here? Was there anything over here? Just an item that I grabbed? Bonfire is that way. Alright, let's go try and mess with this thing. I have a feeling this is like... Like, I think you can kill it. But I'm viewing this as kind of the, you know, kind of like messing with the Hippoclops at the start of Dark Souls 2. Like, yeah, you can kill it. Is it going to be easy? No, it's probably going to molest you. I mean, there's an item. I'm gonna grab that. So at least if I die, I have whatever the thing is. Oh my god, please get off of me! God, oh, this... Oh my god! Guys, I don't want to be a bitch, but I think I'm gonna have to be a bitch. Did you guys just see what that thing did to me with one swing? Let's see how much a pyromancy will do to it. Oh god, no, yeah, there's no fucking way we are killing this thing. Please, sir. Sir, no, do not do this. I literally just tickled its health. Like, tickled. Emphasis on the word tickle. You want to see how much damage we did? Go back and look at how much a pyromancy hit that thing for. No. Not happening. I am not that good. That thing is not dying right now. It'll die in the future. And I have a feeling it's probably gonna, like... It's like, you know what it is? It's like a crystal lizard on freaking steroids. So, I'm gonna make an educated guess that that thing probably drops some really badass upgrade materials. And it's just there to be like, yeah, no, you're not killing me right now. Just go away. Like, go back along. You have zero chance of taking me out. So for those curious how long this part will go, because I know we're already kind of, you know, sure some people are like, well, when does this part end, cowboy? We're going to go all the way up until we reach the hub this episode. So we're going to get to the hub, which means first boss, of course. And then I think next episode might just be me exploring the hub and going through every piece of dialogue and just kind of diving in. Because I'm actually, like, pretty interested in the lore this time around. I mean, I'm not Vaadi, you know, I'm not going to be giving you guys lore breakdowns and analyzing what everything means, but I'm interested myself just to kind of see the lore and, you know, what the relation is to the previous Souls games. Well, that did not work. Come on, get over here. Okay, you know what, you want to be a bitch and guard things? We can deal with you another way. Okay. Asshole. Give me that firebomb. This guy doesn't just look how badass he looks. His ashy face. No! Oh shit, there's an item there. No! No! That's why it was telling me to jump. I need all the items. Need every shiny. Ah, stop. It's gonna turn into a Billy Joel song in a second. Nope! Oh, what the hell? Oh. Okay. Stick is jump. I was trying to press circle while I was running. I don't know. I might switch that back. Oh my god! I am terrible, apparently, at jumps. Fighting cowboy, ladies and gentlemen. Number one jumper, North America. Yay! Titanite shard. I'm actually glad I went and got that. All right, baby. Here we go. It's time for the showdown of the century. Cowboy, a level 1 pyromancer, up against this badass. Calm down there, Undex. Oh, look at you with your big swings. You can't hit me, can ya? Oh, okay. Don't punch me, please. That's rude. This is a weapons fight. Ain't no reason to pull that in. Oh, he's going all tentacle mode. See how you like a little fire! Oh, God. You just got a lot scarier. Oh, yes, you did. Oh, my God. What is this? Wow! Why are you on top of me? It's like he just keeps getting bigger and bigger. What the fuck? Oh, my God. He's so huge now. I'm, like, scared to even approach him. That's gonna hit me. No, it didn't. No, oh my God, I can't pyromancy at all here. I don't know where your windows are. Are you gonna leap? Please don't leap. Nope. Oh man, he could beat me. Jet's saying something, because the knight fucked him up. Oh, he did beat me. EUDEX Gunder just ruined my shit. You know, that's fine. Little death. Just gotta get back into the Souls Mojo. You know, we had, back when we were fighting him in San Francisco, we used the Knight. The Knight was able to just dookie all over him before he could do anything, so we just gotta adjust, you know? Because I really want to do the Pyromancer. I love Pyromancies. Pyromancies have always been my favorite spell type in Dark Souls. And I want to pull this off with the Pyromancer. So we're gonna take you down. Eudex? Let's just call him Gunder. Gunder is easier to say. How about you don't grab me? Oh, boy. No, I do gotta say, not having the buffs that come along with being a knight and having that badass shield, he is in a completely different ballgame here. Okay, here's his angry form. Now, the interesting thing is, when I fought him before, back in San Francisco, like, I never got to really see this form. It just didn't happen, you know, because the knight killed him so fast. That's not what I meant to do. Oh, what the fuck? Okay. I see how it is. Okay, so you have a 3-hit cycle. Alright, so one death just because I was casual. One death learning the mechanics. We know how it works now. That's it. No more scrubbery. Let us go kill the boss. Out of my way, sir. I do not have time for you. Ooh, piece of candy. Alright. Come on, buddy. I'm gonna get all those hard-earned souls back. Ow! Why do you gotta be hitting me when I'm just running for souls, bruh? Do your third swing. Where's it at? Alright, there's your dive. One swing. Come on, you were doing 3 before. Screw it. That's all I need. Get down. give me your sword. You got some lucky kills on me. But that will be the end of them, sir. There will be no more killing, Mr. Cowboy. What is this like? I have like a buff. I have a buff or something. I don't know what that is. Is that... Okay, that's what it is. It's related to my pyromancies. It means pyromancies buffed. Into the big old doors. Broken straight sword. Like, ultimately, I think this will probably become a strength pyromancy type build. Something that uses, like, great swords and then pyromancies. Kind of similar to the build I did with Dark Souls 2 originally. Except that ended up going kind of like pure strength. I mean, we were using double great swords by the end of it. So I don't think it gets much more strength oriented than that. Oh my god. Would you guys please fuck off? What is that? Oh, open menu? Why is there... Why are you telling me that I can open my menu there of all places? Oh! Cowboy with the parry! I gotta say, the ember effect looks totally badass on this kind of, like, cloak I have going on. Like, it looked cool on the knight, because it looked like your armor was, like, on fire, you know? But this looks way more badass, I think. Glowing embers coming out of my cloak. What is it this way? Oh, bad doggy. Okay, that works. Goodbye. Ooh, extra ember. That'll certainly come in handy. Here we are. Oh, man. Firelink Shrine. Home sweet home. It's kind of surreal, like, being here and having this game already. And either way, we are going to wrap things up here. So, as I mentioned earlier, this next episode, I'm just going to kind of dig in-depth into Firelink Shrine, going to explore every nook and cranny of it, going to talk to all the NPCs, stuff like that. Depending on how long that takes, we may just make that an episode in its entirety. From what I've been informed, I'm allowed to show you guys content basically up to Farron's Legion of Undead Walkers, and then I have to hold off until I believe it's April 8th. So, you know, it's like there's no rush here, is the point I'm trying to make. We're going to be having a good time. We're going to be exploring every little bit we can. So, obviously, if you guys don't want spoilers, I would avoid watching this because this is going to be pretty damn spoiler heavy. But either way, I hope you guys are enjoying it. I'm super, super freaking pumped to be playing this right now. Like, 2016 game of the year, baby. Either way, we will catch you guys, you know, tomorrow, maybe later today even. I don't know. We'll see, but there will be more. So, stay tuned.